Hello, my name is Dare Bear, and today we are going to be watching a video of a person that created 5 years ago a top 25 SpongeBob songs, and today we are going to watch it, and I'm going to tell you what I think of them. So let's get started. By the way, Murden, thank you for making this video. By the way, this is the video right here. I won't be song, you'll just hear them. So here we go. Number 25, Idiot Friends. Here you go.
Dana, we got a real special show for y'all tonight, featuring my new best pal, this guy. He's an idiot.
Okay. Can we start singing already?
What are we gonna sing about, SpongeBob?
We're gonna sing a song about friends.
What kind of friends, SpongeBob?
Well, listen up and I'll tell you. Who's there for you when you are sad and down?
Hey!
Idiot friends.
Who picks you up and smacks you all around?
Idiot friends. Who puts thorns in you?
All right.
So you can save the town.
I mean, 25. I mean, this is a good. I think this is. I mean, if it's gonna appear anywhere on the board, it's probably gonna appear 25.
Idiot friends. Idiot friends.
You know, SpongeBob, all we've been doing is singing about what I've done for you. Well, what have you done for me?
Helps you pick your pants up off the ground.
Thanks, buddy.
Curses!
Only an idiot friend would do that.
Let's bring it home, idiot friend.
Okay.
Who let you ride on his coffin?
Who slapped you hard and often?
What do you and me have in common? We're idiot friends.
So that was 25. Number 25, idiot friends. Strap in, because this is probably going to be somewhat 40 minutes. Maybe 50, depending on how long it takes. But let's just see what happens. So I think it would have to just appear at 25. I mean, I don't see where else it would appear. Well, let's see what 24 is.
Thank you very much. Maybe we should just sing the road song.
The road song?
Road.
Really? I didn't think this was going to make the board.
When I'm on the road.
But strap in, this is going to be absolute mess.
Stuff going by.
So believe me, this is one of the songs I actually know that's on this list. And I actually have listened to pretty often. Yeah, just Patrick saying road and SpongeBob saying when I'm on the road. And then someone just fills in that slot. Up until this point, that's all it's been. Stop touching my head. Let's all sing the road song. I wanna sing it all day long. Let's all sing the road song. Let's all sing along. Alright, Patrick, you can stop saying road. And then the car breaks down.
Anybody know any...
Santa's got his jolly little eye on me. I know this isn't Christmas, it's literally in July. But hey, Christmas in July, right? Right? Santa's at number 23. Santa's got his jolly little eye on me from a SpongeBob movie.
Oh, it's drawing very near.
Here, I'll show
my
you
favorite time
that one in case. In case you haven't seen that
the snow
one.
Is falling in the collision glow.
Christmas morning, they only play two SpongeBob episodes. This one, in the very first SpongeBob Christmas, you'll see that song later on the list. The very first SpongeBob Christmas. Make sure. I mean, 23, I don't know if it should stay at 23 or else he's going to... Squidward just wants to end up... Squidward wants to be on Santa's naughty list. Now, I'm just trying to stay on his nice list. I don't want to get on his bad side. You do not want to get on his bad side.
It's a trap. A trap for Santa.
Okay, ooh, bad Patrick, bad.
Christmas treats? I will trap Santa
in my box for Knox and make him
stop the box.
Okay, I don't think Santa can stop time. I mean, maybe. That's what, how he can get to houses so fast.
Hey, a cookie!
Oh, you idiot, Patrick. Remember, I didn't make this. This video was made by Merton. Merton, make sure to check out his channel. Alright. Alright, new. Okay, so at number 23, that was Santa's Got a Jolly Little Eye on Me. I gotta say, it was pretty good. I mean, that was a three-dimensional one. That was a 3D SpongeBob episode. By the way, on Christmas Day, they only show two. If you didn't know, remember, I said this like 2 minutes ago. They show only two episodes. The other one will show up some point later on in the video. Well, number 22, Atlantis SquarePantis. Really, I thought Atlantis was the best. Oh, SpongeBob. SpongeBob, I think you're old. Sorry, that was my Alexa. Oh, not again. Sorry, I keep doing that. Yeah, I can. Tough luck, SpongeBob. Just so you know, this is kind of hurting my ear right now, just with that weird sound in the background. Tough luck, Mr. Krabs. Okay. Can you turn it down, you two? I can hear it even with my ears plugged. Even with my ears plugged, I can still hear it. Alright, he nearly said it right there. Number 21 is Musical Doodle. That one was Atlantis SquarePantis. Musical Doodle is next. I literally played this all around. It just goes round and round. The record spins all day, all around. Here, SpongeBob will show you. As you can see, away, trying to stop at this feudal. So just listen now to my musical doodle. Hard. Electric charge. This is feudal. Okay. I'm shocked this wasn't higher on the list. It's just so catchy. Go doodle. Sorry, I kind of got it stuck in my head. Let this doodle. So just listen now to my musical doodle. Do 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 do. Yeah, musical doodle. Sorry. Alright, Bubble Song. This is on the actual SpongeBob playlist, the Bubble Song. The song's only a minute long, and it's about bubbles. here. SpongeBob will show you exactly how bubbles work. Yes.
At the end of every day.
True, SpongeBob.
And the curtain must fall at the end of every day.
Unfortunately, SpongeBob, that is actually true.
Every little bubble ever blown must someday pop.
Very true, SpongeBob. We just had a Christmas song back on 23, and we're on 20. It doesn't last all day. I will try again to blow a bubble that will last all day. Unfortunately, SpongeBob, that's not how bubbles work. Unfortunately, bubbles cannot last all day, SpongeBob. Unless you're in Atlantis, apparently. Because that's in the same episode as Atlantis SquarePantis. Oh, no, not... Oh, Patty. This song... In this episode, SpongeBob falls in love with a Patty.
They may call me a fool.
Yes, I call you a fool. Yeah, and it's pushing you away from it. No, don't stuff a Krabby Patty with cotton candy, you idiot. I don't think they have arms. Believe me, this song... I mean, after 6 hours, a Krabby Patty rots, in case you didn't know that. And then a bunch of clams attack the Krabby Patty. Once again, just so you know, clams equal birds. Like snails equal cats and worms equal dogs. It sounds like he's doing karate, except he's just running around like crazy. No. Yeah, right. Man, okay, just so you know, we are only 10 minutes into this, out of 37. And we are at about the 13 minute mark on the video. Yeah, nope. Yeah, I just gotta cut that one. And then... It gets disassembled in water. No. Stop. Yeah, and the thing, it can't get any worse after getting eaten by clams. It goes in water. What's time for the Texas candy? Song.
Maybe it's just...
Up next is the Texas song, number 18. I mean, I guess it works at 18. I didn't see it coming. I think it's them singing about dumb old Texas. Texas isn't dumb, by the way. It's just what they say.
Just a squirrel thing.
Wish I was back in Texas.
Oh, here we go. It's Sandy's version. It's actually Sandy's version, not SpongeBob's version, which involves them saying Texas is dumb. Which it isn't, actually. As Sandy says, it's the prettiest place on earth. Yeah, wide open skies. Texas sees a lot of those. They actually try to create Texas at the Krusty Krab in this episode. The only problem is they use barbecues, not barbecues. And instead of pecan pie, which is a nut pie, they use a can of peas jammed in a pie and square dancing. You dance with a square. Okay, who said that? Alright, who's 17? Alright, number 17. Oh, couldn't have been a more simpler name. I wrote this song. This couldn't be any more simpler. Let's play. I sound like this is Patrick. Ah! Why does it keep saying boinky, boinky, boinky? Yeah, so I'm playing. Boinky, boinky, boinky. Okay. Alright, number 16. Now that we're men. Now, SpongeBob. You're a 16-year-old sponge. Really? And then this is what happens, and they think now they are men. Literally, they get kelp on their face. And now they think they're men. Seriously, SpongeBob, you're 16. Be smarter than that. Well, this is SpongeBob. And Patrick. This is sounds like the song a marching band would play. Yeah, this seems basically like a marching band song. I'm not saying it's bad. It is actually very, very good, actually. Wait, you didn't change your underwear? Now that you're men, you change your underwear? Wait, did Patrick not use to change his underwear? That's disgusting. SpongeBob, why are you friends with this guy? Wait, who's slapping who? So it says, let's do some slapping. What are they slapping? Oh, I know, their faces. Ow. Like that. Except opposite faces. Like SpongeBob hits Patrick like this, and then Patrick hits SpongeBob a little something more like this. Like, the only problem, yeah, just kind of goes back. SpongeBob goes with the full hand back. And then this weird guy with very spiky shoes shows up and lures his foot over them at one point in the episode. And then a random shoe just falls on him. Alright, remember what I said back on like song 23? All the way back when it was number 23 on the list, we would have another Christmas song. This is the very first Christmas one. They literally cut down Squidward's coral tree. Hey, isn't that theft? They took his coral tree, and isn't that awesome? Don't they have to pay for that? I'd say Squidward can probably earn about $3,000. I mean, SpongeBob's net worth is $1 million. I mean, SpongeBob is literally getting paid minimum wage. And he's still very happy about it. Well, this is the very first Christmas. Of course he's happy. What do you want? Can't you see that I'm busy? Step outside, we've got something for you. SpongeBob, take this stuff down immediately. They decorated for... Whoops, I accidentally dropped our... Feels like the very first Christmas to me! And Mr. Krabs! Ark, 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 ark. Alright. Here we go. Now, I don't really agree with this placement. At number 14, the best day ever. Some people might also agree with me. I think it should be higher up the board, but let's just see why. Dun, 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 dun. Mr. Sun came up and he smiled at me. Said it's gonna be a good one, just wait and see. I've been on point with SpongeBob. Jumped out of bed and I ran outside, feeling so ecstatic, satisfied. It's the best day ever. I mean, come on, you gotta love this guy. I'm so busy, got nothing to do. Well, how can you be so busy? Oh no, did you forget how to tie your shoe again? Sand is reaching out to shake my hand. It's the best day ever. It was the best day ever. Make sure to check in one of my other videos where I talk about the greatest ending of a game that I've encountered, and usually I'm the guy that always blows it. That's a true fact. I pretty much blow everything. I wanna lose that ground. I stick my head in the thunder when I look around. The clouds don't scare me, they can't disguise. It's magic that's happening right before our eyes. Mr. Moon will be shining bright. The best day ever can. It's the best day ever, it's gonna last all night, yeah. It's the best. This is actually on the opposite ends of the song. If you saw that cut, that's switching from the literal beginning of the episode to the literal end. Yeah, so this side of my camera is beginning, and then they would play all the way over here till the end. I mean, they started the song right about here and ended literally at the end of the whole episode. Well, I believe it's time for number 13 on the list. Let's reveal. All right, Merlin, let's see what you got at 13. Oh, jellyfish jam. Okay, yeah, so it's and that song. And that was because a bunch of jellyfish took over his house and partied all night. So here we go. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm. Gotta love it. Love it. Like it, love it, want more of it. Hold on, I gotta move positioning real quick. There we go. At the 25-minute mark. In the actual video here, we're at the 21-minute mark. Love it. Like it, love it, want more of it. I really wish this was top 10, because I really think it would be a lot better, but hey, I didn't make this video. Murden, make sure to check out that channel. They're the creators of this top 25. If you like this channel, check out their channel. They've got some really great content over there. So we got Jellyfish Jam here. I mean, yeah, you hear this one in a lot of stadiums. During a sporting event, you usually hear this one. Moving on to number 12. Grab pizza, get the pizza, the Diffily. Okay. SpongeBob is literally singing about pizza. Really?
Pizza is the pizza at the Diffily. Pizza, pizza, pizza.
I'm not going to try.
Pizza, it's a pizza for you and me.
Alright, this is an interesting one. To be honest, I didn't even know the song existed. Living in the Sunlight, number 11. Top 10. Kind of a so-so. But, hey, that's pretty good. It's pretty good. Oh, no, not the Rippin' Pants episode. Top 10, barely clipping the top 10. All sky high. And now she won't even spare a passing glance. All just because I ripped my pants. You have to admit it's a bit funny. When he just rips his pants over and over. Literally, the first time he did it, when he was lifting a literal stick with two marshmallows. I mean, his workout routine is, well, a pole with two teddy bears on it. Like, that's going to help you, Al. But he went with a stick and two marshmallows and couldn't lift it off the ground. So when at Larry's gym, he got a cotton swab with two cotton balls and it absolutely flattened his arms. What a total noob. Well, won't end up like a fool. Who ripped his pants? Rip. Whoops, I think I might have ripped mine. Just kidding.
That's no problem, ladies and germs, because SpongeBob is here to use that as
well. No, not striped sweater. When SpongeBob thinks he's a singing star.
I like to call this little number striped sweater.
The best time to wear a striped sweater is all the time.
I might have to turn up the volume. Oh man, this is absolutely garbage. All right, at number 8. Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people.
Amazing. I've got to tell someone about this. Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people, won't you listen to me?
Wait, what the? Hey, all you people, won't you listen to me? And then just cut to Gary come home. What the?
I've got to tell someone about this. Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people, won't you listen to me?
Just kidding. I won't listen to you, apparently, because your segment just got cut. Tough luck. Tough luck, Fred. Tough luck. Well, hey, that's how it works. Well, up next on the list, we got Gary Come Home. Oh, man, not this one. To be honest, I even want it replaced with Where's Gary? I'll play that one for you at the end of the video, and then you can tell me which you would want.
Gary, now I know I was wrong. I messed up, and now you're gone. Gary, I'm sorry I neglected you. Oh, I never expected you to run away and leave me feeling this empty. You want me out right now would sound like music to me. Please come home, cause I miss you, Gary.
Gary, come home.
Gary, come home. Yes, yeah, so Gary, could you please come home already? Because SpongeBob doesn't have a single
chance.
I mean, SpongeBob got so many unfortunate breaks. He walked away right as Gary walked past. Unfortunate.
More than a pet, you're my best friend. Too cool to forget. Come back, cause we are family. And forgive me for being you out of Rome. Now my heart is...
We're approaching the top 5. The best of the best. Oh, he's asking him to read his 3-word poem, Gary, come home. That's his 3-word poem, Gary, come home. All right, well, come on. We still gotta contemplate a few more songs here. And then I will play Where's Gary for you. A song that made the audio files, but was never even used. Keep note on that. This song has not been used, but made the audio files. And it was replaced by this song right here, Gary Come Home. And it was kind of a battle between what the producers wanted and where Gary Come Home came on top. Alright. Oh, boy. Down in Alton, while we were down there, a player by the name of Blake Guerin, one of the players played a prank, decided to play a prank on him, and this made him walk up to the plate with this song.
Come on, let me spell it for you. F is for friends who do stuff together.
I mean, I like this placement, except I would like it top 5. I would like a top 5 fun song. I think SpongeBob would like it. I think it would be fine if the fun song was...
Town, you
use for uranium. Bombs. N is for no survivors. When you're
Plankton. Those things aren't what fun is all about. Now, do it like this. F is for friends who do stuff.
That's completely idiotic.
Here, let me help you. F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me.
Try it.
N is for anywhere and anytime and all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
Wait, I don't understand this. I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it. Let's do it again.
Okay. F is for frolic through all the flowers. U is for ukulele.
Cherry gum is not like me with my best buddy. All right, guys, you can stop laughing. This is driving me nuts. But once again, I'm making this. Oh boy. Okay, interesting pick at number 5, campfire song. Yes, I said song on purpose. Here.
I call this one the campfire song.
Hmm?
Let's gather around the campfire
and sing our campfire song. Our C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. And if you don't think that we can sing it faster, then you're wrong. But it'll help if you just sing along. Boom, boom, boom. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. If you don't think that we can sing it better, then you're wrong. But it'll help if you just sing along. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. Patrick song. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E Squidward. Good. It'll help if you just sing along. By the way, this actually took place in the episode Squidward got absolutely mauled by a sea bear. Oh, brother, I don't see how this was number 4. Loop-de-loop, about tying your shoe. Because SpongeBob somehow forgot how to tie his shoe. Because apparently they've been tied for some 15 years. Just keep notice, this video was made 5 years ago. That was at the time when I was 6. I was 6 when this video was made. Okay, that's the whole song for you. Loop-de-loop. All right, now here we go. The top 3. The best of the best. Let's see it. Number 3. Goofy Goober Rock. Not the Goofy Goober song. Goofy Goober Rock.
Because I did what everyone said a kid couldn't do. I made it to Shell City, and I beat the Cyclops, and I rode the Hasselhoff, and I brought the crown back.
Alright, we get the point.
So yeah, I'm a kid, and I'm also a goofball, and a wingnut, and a
knucklehead that stands for Kong.
What's going on here?
But most of all, I'm a Goofy Goober Rock. You're a Goofy Goober Rock. We're all Goofy Goober Rock. Goofy 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 Goober Rock. Push your toes away. Well, I gotta say, don't play, say no way. No. I'ma keep you safe. Say it again. Thank you very much. So if you're thinking that you'd like to be like me, go ahead, try. Get inside, we'll set you free. I'm a Goofy Goober Rock. Gary Goofy Goober, rah! We're Goofy Goober, rah!
But I'm in control!
Goofy Goober, rah! Oh yeah, this deserved the top three slot. There are only 4 minutes left. Well, the next two videos have to be some 2 minutes long. Alright, well, we will show you what. Oh, he's got a pew-pew! I think he's using his guitar right now as a laser. How? Hey, this is the SpongeBob world. I don't know what happens. Sorry, I had something in my eye. Oh, and it's some. Oh boy. I don't get how in the world is this number two. Probably the greatest performance of. But it's at the Bubble Bowl. The 01 Bubble Bowl. And it's halftime. And all of a sudden, this dome rises up, and these little fish holding musical instruments play this.
Let's get this over with. 1, 2, 3.
As you can see, the crowd is ecstatic. 4. Yeah, this is Squidward's reaction. Plankton just starts going bing bing. What the? Okay, we have a technical. We had a little technical difficulty. It appears the person that made this video, remember this is in 2018, we don't have the. And also, yeah, we've got some low quality here. How the world goes in it. In that same episode, he has this friendship. Oh, not again. You've got to be kidding. By the way, don't think it's on your end. It's not a problem on your end. It's just this video over here is having some technical difficulties. This is the number one according to them. A stove is a stove. Why do I say a stove is a stove? A stove is a stove. It's Mr. Krabs and SpongeBob single.
Not the stuff.
Whoops, accidentally clicked something. Well, here we go.
Good morning, Camp Chewy.
Okay, Chewy's not a spot. So I will pull up. Where's Gary for you? Yeah, just let me. Just give me about a minute. Give me a little bit first. Let me just look up that. Go onto that. It's on the SpongeBob Greatest Hits on Amazon Music. Be sure to check that out. It's the number 6 song, Where's Gary? Here we go. Give me a thumbs up if this is better than Gary Come Home. Come Home. And if you think Gary Come Home should stay, hit the subscribe. Hit that big red subscribe button down there if Gary Come Home is better. Little sign, a trail of slime he left behind, cause I'm so lonely all the time. Oh, where has Gary gone? Yeah, play it, SpongeBob. This would have been a 3-minute song. So I'll just play the first minute. Okay, so I'm going to make sure to check out all our other videos, and for now, bye!